What a lot of my friends don't understand that racism could happen to me in this town. I was golfing in a golf tournament with Bruce Bowen. And Bruce and I were with two other, there were two executives. It was a charity tournament. And we were on the number 5 hole at La Cantera. And it was right there next to that little La Cantera Parkway. And we're on the green putting, and a guy drives by in a service truck and he yells, "Hey, niggers," just as loud as he could. And you could see the two white guys that were with us, they were shocked. They didn't know what to say. I don't think they acted like they hadn't experienced anything like that. Bruce and I were, you know, kind of like, okay, you know, that happens occasionally, but we just didn't expect it to happen at that point. And it was just, you know, sometimes you get a rude awakening and you get reminded. But I would never hold that against all white people or the people of San Antonio. It's just that it happens still to this day. It happened when I was in elementary school, and it happens now. It doesn't matter who you are. If I'm in another city and I get on an elevator with people, lots of times I have to diffuse the situation because people are scared. They're scared of me. Isn't that amazing? I want her to fly. All my black friends, I have friends that are very successful. One of my friends is a pilot for Delta. And we talk about the same thing. You know, every single day when I leave my house, whenever I go to the store, whenever I do an interview, whenever I talk to somebody on the phone, whenever I interact with people, there's always this pressure on me to represent. You know, I've got to represent the black race to the best of my ability. I've always felt that pressure. I don't know that other people of other races feel that way when they interact with people. Do you feel that pressure to, you know, represent, you know, where you come from, or, you know, people that have the same color skin as you? You know, do you feel that pressure to smash stereotypes that people have about you? I have so many people over the years, I mean, tell me things like, "Hell, you're a breath of fresh air. You're not like the rest of them." I've had people tell me, "Oh, you think you're white because of the way I talk." And I've gotten that not only from white people, but I've gotten it from black people, because there's this, you know, we've been so ingrained with racism and stereotypes that, you know, we even have blacks that say that to each other. "Oh, you think you're white? Why would I think I'm white? I love being a black man."